They now bade goodbye to the Professor, and thanking him for his kind reception, mounted again into the red wagon and continued their journey. End of Chapter 9. Chapter 10. How the Cuttenclips Lived. The travelers had taken no provisions with them, because they knew that they would be welcomed wherever they might go in the Land of Oz, and that the people would feed and lodge them with genuine hospitality. So about noon they stopped at a farmhouse and were given a delicious luncheon of bread and milk, fruits and wheat cakes with maple syrup. After resting a while and strolling through the orchards with their host, a round, jolly farmer, they got into the wagon and again started the Sawhorse along the pretty, winding road. There were signposts at all the corners, and finally they came to one which read, "Take this road to the Cuttenclips." There was a hand pointing in the right direction, so they turned the Sawhorse that way, and found it a very good road, but seemingly little traveled. "I've never seen the Cuttenclips before," remarked Dorothy.
"Nor I," said the Captain General.
"Nor I," said the Wizard.
"Nor I," said Billina.
"I've hardly been out of the Emerald City since I arrived in this country," added the Shaggy Man.
"Why, none of us has been there, then," exclaimed the little girl. "I wonder what the Cuttenclips are like."
"We'll soon find out," said the Wizard with a sly laugh. "I've heard they are rather flimsy things."
The farmhouses became fewer as they proceeded, and the path was at times so faint that the Sawhorse had hard work to keep in the road. The wagon began to jounce, too, so they were obliged to go slowly. After a somewhat wearisome journey they came in sight of a high wall painted blue with pink ornaments.